Good morning, everybody. Mm-hmm. Everybody smiling? Okay, good. So, yesterday I was talking with somebody and that person sent me a message, Bhante, can I talk to you? So always I have emergency situations and people want to talk to me. Then I said, okay, please call me. Then I start to talk with that person. So then other side of the phone I can hear this person is crying. So then I thought, I want to ask, why are you crying? So then she made the big list why she is crying and worrying. So the first thing she said, I was listening to her, she said, my boss at work, she doesn't like me. That's why she is crying, my boss doesn't like me. Then second thing she said, why I am sad and disappointed, maybe I will lose my job. That's another thing. And the third thing she said, my parents doesn't like me either. Then my parents said, don't come home, you know, we give up on you. And now the last thing I feel alone. So much things going on in my life, I don't know what I had to do. So think about those things, what she said. Then I had, you know, almost I talked with her 1 hour. So now she is crying and she asking what I am going to do now. So then I was thinking, now the message I want to give it to you, think about our life. When you or me, when we talk about the life always difficult. Think about how many years we are living in this world. Most of times we are happy or unhappy. It's a question. You know, our lifetime, most of time we are enjoying our life or we are worrying about our life. Right. So I was thinking.
Worrying
about yes, we, you know, that means we are worrying about this life. See, we are all worrying. So then I was thinking, everything, whatever we are worrying or things happen to this body. Right? Then I was thinking what Buddha said, you know, the people don't like to hear that life is suffering, no matter what. That's the thing Buddha said. But most of Westerners, they don't like to hear that. Life is suffering. So then I was thinking, listen to her list, why she is worrying. I thought, Buddha is perfectly right. Right? Life is suffering, of course. Losing the job, losing the people, we don't like each other. And that means most of time we are complaining about this life. We can complain 24/7 if you want to. That means a lot of pain and grief and suffering. Think about after we born to this world, everything happened to this life. After we born to this life, what is the first thing happened to this life? Right after we born? That's pain, right? That's a painful experience. Then day by day, moment by moment, what is happening? Getting old. Right after we born, the moment by moment, day by day, week by week, we are getting old. Is it fun getting old?
No.
So after we born to this world, then we are getting old. Then little by little, day by day, moment by moment, what is happening to this body? Painful, sick, and all those things happening. Then what happened? Then we get the people and things to this life. Then we are losing people. Then we have grief and attachment. Everything happened to this body, happened to this life. So then Buddha said, even a moment, I don't say this life is fun. You know, we always say life is beautiful. Of course, life is beautiful. But Buddha said, life is always suffering. Sounds like very negative, right? Sounds like very negative. If you think it is negative, that means you are going to suffer more. Right? So this is not negative, this is the way it is. Then the last thing I was thinking, what she said, I feel alone. I feel alone. I don't have anybody. Sometime one day, one person, long time ago, maybe a year or two ago, one person called and said, Bhante, I'm really sick, I don't have anybody. Can I come to your house and sleep on your in your living room? I felt so sad about that person. Then I sent other monks to pick that person, and that person was sick. Then she came to my house, living in my, sleeping in my living room like almost 2 days. Because she said, I don't have anybody. Then we all help that person. So think about when we feel alone, what is that means? That is suffering too. Right? When we feel alone, all these people complaining, oh, I feel alone. Then what do you want to do when you feel alone? What you are doing? Suffering. Then what you want to do when you feel that? What kind of things, what kind of activities, what kind of reactions?
Eat,
right? Eat. Okay, that, think about that. Then what happened? There's another suffering. That moment, that moment we feel good, then there's another suffering happened because, the getting the weight and, sick and all those things happen. Then when we feel alone, what kind of things we are doing? We want to distract. To overcome that difficulty, we want to distract. So Buddha said, what we have to do when we feel those things, we have to accept it. We have to accept it. But we don't like to accept it. We want to fix it right away. The first thing, we want to distract. How we are going to distract? How you are going to get distracted when you feel alone?
Watch TV.
Watch TV. Then what happened? There's another suffering.
Yeah.
That means you get more suffering from the outside world, watching the television, wars and fighting, killing each other, then you get angry. So you are collecting information. Then you want to, when you feel alone again, there's another thing I experience, what you want to do, we want to associate with somebody. That means we want to call somebody. I want to call my friend. So one day I was driving from Geneva after meditation class. Almost 45 minutes I had to drive, come back home, return home. So then I'm thinking, and then I thought, I feel alone. Now with these 45 minutes I cannot wait. Right? Because I don't have anything, I'm just driving. I thought, I want to call Chan, other monk who live with me, right now who is living in Florida. Then I thought, no, that's my, I am not aware about my feeling. Because this moment I feel kind of alone myself, I want to distract with somebody. Then I thought, after I talking to him, what kind of things I am going to talk? Maybe talking about the people, maybe talking about the other monks, or, maybe gossiping or something like that. Then I realized that, then I thought, no need to. What I had to do, I had to accept that my feeling, I had to live with it. Then I had a really good time. I really enjoy my drive and I really had the good time. Otherwise, what we are doing, we are making more suffering. More suffering. So think about all those experiences we are going through in this life. We don't have that much time to enjoy this life. So much time we are worrying and sad. Then life is not beautiful. Life is not beautiful. How we are going to make this life beautiful then? I think all of you, when you come to meditation, including myself, we all have some issues. We all have some issues. Do you agree?
Yeah.
We all have. I have a lot. Right? That's why I keep doing this meditation and practicing and Whoever come to meditation, I don't say you are bad, but we all have that problem. People who are sitting on the cushion and practicing meditation, they have problems, some issues. And people who are outside, they have more than us. Right? Even they don't know how to deal with them. Maybe they are running around. You are so fortunate to come here and even get some time to think about it. So how we are going to create this life peaceful then, or wonderful or beautiful? How we are going to do this? Any thought?
Acceptance of it.
Acceptance and, what?
And being able to, instead of pushing away or denying the pain or the loneliness or whatever feeling, emotion, it's to go to it, depth it,
right.
Be with it, give it space, spend time with it, and in the end, sometimes, if you let it, you can take the power release from that.
Right, exactly, that's the thing. First thing what you have to do, we have to accept the nature of this situation, nature of this life. Right after we accept that, then we can work, you know, think about when I feel alone, I want to distract with somebody, I want to make a phone call or talking to somebody. So it is okay to talking to somebody right after I realize what is the problem going on with me. So I was thinking I want to call another monk and say hi to him. So before that I realize what is my problem. Having that, you know, the idea and wisdom, then I can talk to that person. Then that discussion will be a wonderful and peaceful and wisdomful discussion. Otherwise, I am giving that person trouble, my trouble, and worrying, and then we both are suffering. So, now what you have to do, accept all the situation in your life. It doesn't matter what is happening, getting old, getting sick, you know, the boredom, difficult people, difficult issues in your life. Whole thing is life. We cannot separate from those things. That's why Buddha said life is suffering. Right after you come to this world, everything is on your plate. Then you have to decide how to deal with it. If you cannot deal with it, that means until you die you are going to suffer. So if you understand that true nature, then even life is difficult, you can enjoy it. You can enjoy it. So this morning somebody talked with me, then I said always, you know, that we have options. Suffering is optional. So you have to decide whether you are going to take it or not, right? So think about mindfully and accept the all the nature of this life and enjoy each moment. Otherwise, life is very difficult, painful, ugly experience. So one time I remember when I was in Sri Lanka, I was visiting my mother. Then I saw she was crying. She was crying. I asked, why are you crying? Because I know she doesn't have any issues or problems or to worry. I know the physical problem we all have to deal with. Then she said, I don't have any problem. Something happened to the neighbor's, you know, the neighbor's house. That's why I'm worrying. Now she took the worrying from other people. If you don't have anything to worry, we are taking worrying from somebody else and we are making suffering. We are welcoming the suffering sometimes. Sometimes I realize people really enjoy the suffering. You know, sometimes really enjoy the suffering. People like the suffering. Sometimes I will say, this is difficult, right? Yes, difficult, but still I like it. Sometimes I'm explaining to people, you know, this is the problem. But still they are so attaching to that problem. Still they are telling me, oh, I have this problem and that problem. Then I explain to people, you know, focus on, if you know the problem, then we can work on it. But the problem with the people, they don't like to give up that. Then I said, have fun with suffering. So I told a couple of people last week, they are explaining their difficulties and issues and problems. Then when I give them like an answer, this is the way you have to deal with it, they don't like to accept that. Still they are attaching to that. That means I call the enjoying the suffering. Then I said, okay, have fun. Right? Don't tell me anymore. Right? So, any thoughts or any questions about that? How you are dealing with this difficult life? Jason?
You talked about the word loneliness. Mm-hmm. You know, when I feel down or sad or I don't feel good or sometimes one of the emotions that comes up is loneliness.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the main one.
And so then, you know, oh, well, should I make a phone call? Should I do this? Should I do that? And, you know, I'll go and try to spend some time with people.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then I'll notice that these people are just aggravating me. And then I think to myself, all right, I want to go back and just be by myself.
Right, exactly. That's the thing happen always.
So it's very ironic. You know?
Yeah,
like,
that's why I said, when you experience that, be with it first. And watch it and observe it. What is going on inside my mind now? Right? People cannot wait. People right away, they want to distract. Right? That's the problem. That's totally right. You know, anything?
I remember reading something about if you have an ongoing problem, that you've chosen to continue the problem rather than the solution, and that when you have decided that the problem no longer serves its purpose, then the solution will present itself.
Yes, exactly.
That a lot of people don't realize is that even though, sure, there may be times when you're feeling down or you feel like you don't have what you want or things, you're lonely or things in life just aren't going the way that you want, you have to keep in mind that there are several people in this world who would gladly, who would be more than willing to trade life. Say if you are mourning someone who has passed, be grateful for the time that you spend with them. If you think that you don't have what you want, be grateful for what you have.
Right, exactly.
Just, if anything, if you miss something, just be grateful for what you have. You just be grateful for the time that you have.
Yeah.
You step with it because if you think about what you have or the time and focus more on the good times, you realize that you don't, that despite feeling bad.
Yeah, that's a good comment.
That you can still find happiness and realize what you have and what you have.
Thank you, thank you. Any other thought about your experience?
Just the irony of you can feel lonely and then you can realize other people are lonely.
Right, we all are.
Still community. And,
right, exactly. Right. Yeah. Any thought?
Well, I know my daughter emailed me and said that she was feeling lonely because she's not dating right now. I said, well, people that are dating are lonely.
Right, exactly. That's totally right. Right? So think about when people feel lonely, then they are going and it's okay to find somebody if you want to, but still people complaining. So after they find that person, then they come to me and you know, Bhante, I felt lonely, then I found somebody, now I don't like that person. Then there's another problem. So I think always problem within, not, you know, the, you know, outside world, without. Right? So try to find the answer, what we are doing, going suffering to suffering, problem to another problem. Without solving your problem, you are creating double, you know, more. So my point always, you know, that what I am trying to experience myself, first realize the problem. What is wrong with me? Then, if you want to talk with other people, then it will be fine. Then you know who you are. My reaction and my difficulty. Any other questions? Yeah.
Just one thing for myself. I have found that sometimes even now are manufactured problems by me. And when I go into the looking at it through the nature way, I find that there really isn't a problem when you look deep at it.
Right.
It's a perception that I've made that caused my own suffering.
Right. Yeah.
So being by myself and thinking it through, most of the time, I found that in the past I had all that bundled up,
right.
But now it's kind of like, this really isn't a problem.
Problem.
I'm just thinking it's a problem.
Right, exactly. That means you're creating the problem. Yeah.
Yeah. Or being
suffer that they don't want to give it up? What's the desire in doing that?
Right.
What causes that desire?
You know, the attachment, you know, the people don't, other thing is the delusion, ignorance.
Yeah.
That's the thing, delusion and ignorance. That's the only, you know, the cause for that.
I think it can be gathered too. It seems like some people are just losing that frame of mind. They're going to find something maybe to worry about or whatever.
Or it serves some story they tell themselves about themselves and worthiness or unworthiness.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, ego. There's so many reasons. So many reasons. Any other thought?
Yeah. We always try to find somebody to blame or something else to blame.
Right.
Parents didn't raise me right.
Right.
Wife isn't paying that. You know, mm-hmm. Always should be there.
Yeah.
Looking at ourselves.
Yes.
Always trying to find
somebody to, you know. You know, that's always I'm telling people, if you really want to enjoy this life, you have to take the responsibility for everything. It doesn't matter good or bad. Right? If you did something good, you know, you are responsible. If you did something wrong, you know, bad, you are responsible for both. So the way we are reacting always, if something bad happened, always we are pointing fingers for other people. You did this. You did this. You did this. If something good happened, always I did it. Right? That's the way we are. You did it or I did it. You know, good things I did it, bad things you did it. So that means we don't like to take the responsibility.
One thing that I've learned is that many things and things that have happened in life has happened because of several different people or several different events leading up to it. Like, say if something bad happened to you, maybe, just maybe, you had done something in the past, like something really simple that you weren't thinking about that may have led up to it. Or, but you may not blame yourself for it. But if you, or someone had done something and they tried blaming you for it, but then it turns out that later they had done something to cause it.
Thank you. You have any more people? No suffering. No suffering. Great. any other questions?
Yes. What is the connection between suffering and karma? Is there, or is that like a giant question?
Yeah, it's a giant question, you know. So there is no, you know, the perfect answer for that. Maybe there is, you know, some connection, not always. Once Buddha said, karma is not everything, right? Karma is not everything. It depends what your action, what you are doing right now, right? So always, whatever I talk today, you can face to it, you can have a solution, and also you can enjoy the life. That's why I always thinking, I know life is suffering, but always we can enjoy it, if we really facing to the reality. The problem with the people, they don't like to face into the reality, and they try to push out the reality and try to enjoy this life. That means you are creating more difficulties and problems. Right? So life is still good, and really, please enjoy it. So, thank you.